G'day. Called the Supreme Minister of Beauty by his contemporaries, Antonio Canova is considered the greatest sculptor of his time.
He was born in 1757 in the Italian village of Passagno. It is a region that is significant to many residents of Griffith, where around half of the population were born in Italy or are descended from Italian migrants. Antonio Canova's father was a stonecutter, as was his grandfather, who would take care of the boy after 1762 when his mother remarried.
As a boy, Antonio began working with his grandfather, and in 1770 became his apprentice. His skill was evident, and it soon led him to study at an academy.
During the next decade, he was commissioned to produce statues that won praise and renown. In 1780, Antonio Canova arrived in Rome, where he continued studying by sketching the works of greats like Michelangelo. Antonio's sculptures were so realistic that he was accused of making plaster casts from live models. At that time, there was a revival of interest in the culture of ancient Greece, which would become known as neoclassical.
Neo, meaning new, and classical, referring to an old style.
Simply put, neoclassical is a new take on an old style, and it is one for which Antonio would become famous. Art he created during the 1790s included Psyche revived by Cupid's Kiss, which is shown in terracotta reductions here at Pioneer Park Museum. Sculpture is a three-dimensional art form, and the original life-size work was designed to be viewed from multiple angles. There had been many representations of this classic Greek myth during Antonio's time, and he drew inspiration from a painting found in Naples. In the early 19th century, Antonio would gain increasing fame and was invited to create artwork for the conqueror Napoleon Bonaparte and his wife Josephine. A copy of the bust of the famous conqueror is included in the collection at Pioneer Park Museum. In 1816, he returned to Rome with art that had been taken by Napoleon during his conquest of Europe. For his service, Antonio was given the title Marquis and a pension. With this income, he began work on a temple, Tempio Canaviano, in his hometown of Passagno.
Antonio would not see the temple completed in his lifetime, as he would die in Venice at the age of 64.
On 25th of October 1822, his body was placed in the Tempio Canaviano. In 1826, the remaining plaster models and sculptures in Canova's studio were moved to Passagno to be installed at the Gipsoteca, where they can still be seen today, and also, of course, at Pioneer Park Museum.